Well, she is now officially the Chancellor of the Empire, and there are a lot of struggles that come with that. And also, as you might have noted in the trailer, there's a bit of a new aesthetic going on. And that's a really exciting addition that has been made. It's inspired by Glenn Hetrick, who's our designer, who's a huge Trek fan himself. At Alchemy Studios, he was inspired by season 6, episode 23 of The Next Generation, Rightful Heir. There is a reference when Kalish is brought back as a clone, unbeknownst to Worf at the beginning of the episode. The way he proves himself is he tells the story of how he cut off a lock of his hair and dipped it into the a volcano and water, and made the first Batleth, with which he killed Molor, the terrible tyrant who was running Kronos at the time. So, in the spirit of discovery, we took that one little beautiful seed that was planted from an earlier iteration and kind of expanded upon that. And we see that in a time of war, the Klingons would shave their heads, and in a time of peace, we start to grow back out. And I really love the symbolism of that. I think there's also a theme for Laurel in the second season of embracing her femininity as she embraces her power, which I think the two can coexist. So I really enjoyed that.
Who here knows the story of how this sword was forged?
No one knows. It is not written in the sacred texts.
I went into the mountains. All the way to the volcano at Kristat. There I cut off a lock of my hair and thrust it into the river of molten rock that poured from the summit. The hair began to burn. Then I plunged it into the lake of the saw and twisted it into this sword. And after I used it to kill Molor, I gave it a name. Batleth, the Sword of Honor.